G'day fellas, how you going? In the world of creating creative stuff, whether it be music, art or cosplay, everyone has an opinion about something. This can be really good because with a bunch of different opinions, it always gives way for the potential for a variety of different artworks to be created each and every single day. But with opinions comes feedback, or as some like to call it, constructive criticism, which depending on how it's delivered or how it's received by people, it can really make or break an artist. So the question here is, what is good criticism, what is bad criticism? What advice should we actually listen to? And if we need to, what's the best way to actually give proper feedback to someone without coming across as a complete wanker? So that's what we're going to talk about in today's video. Let's go. First things first, for the most part, feedback is awesome. Now, it's great to have a vision, to have a passion to really create something, but we usually tend to have just one point of view, which is our own, and at times that can get rather limiting. You've probably heard the saying before, two heads are better than one, yeah? Well, that must also mean that 100 heads must be better than two, right? Now, having a variety of different opinions on a creative subject can be really valuable because it means you can get new ideas, new insights into different things, and it can really help reaffirm your decision for tough subjects, like if you actually need to put that extra layer of trim around the corner of your costume, or if it's better off just you getting some extra sleep the night before a convention. Now, at times it can be very difficult to take on feedback because in a way, if you have a bunch of different opinions which differ from your own, it can sometimes weaken your own resolve or seem like your own original idea wasn't that great in the first place. But in the end, it can really be valuable just to get different opinions or insights on even your own thoughts and just seeing what other people think about it, because in the end, your opinion, your decision will be your own to make. But it can be great just having those variety of opinions there just to weigh up the options. That being the case, if you get 2 opinions, 5 opinions, 10 or 100 opinions, which ones are actually worth listening to? Now this is where people say, oh, it's just constructive criticism, but criticism can quite literally just be criticism instead of actual genuine feedback on something. I mean, sometimes you'll hear people giving constructive criticism sounding something like, now, I don't mean to be rude, but that jacket's not really well made. You know, this is just my opinion, but that jacket's not great. Look, just for me, that jacket, yeah, nah. And as a human, if someone was just wanting to point out the flaws in something that we made, we wouldn't really want to listen to them. But all criticism is constructive. Look, if you're really just pointing out flaws, it's not really constructive. If you're just that random guy who goes up to someone and points out the different things you don't like about something, you basically become that basement-dwelling hermit fella who becomes something like, you know, I've watched all 48 episodes, those 2 movies, and I run the online fan club for that series, so that does make me a bit of an expert on the subject. Just pointing out things that went wrong with something or things that you don't like about a particular subject, that's just called criticism. And without even giving some insight on how it could have been better or giving them a criticism when they didn't even ask for it, that's just called being a wanker. I mean, some kind of potential improvement does need to be suggested in order to be even started to be called constructive criticism, but a better term would be called good feedback. So this brings us to ask, what exactly is good feedback? I mean, the only time it's really suitable feedback to ever be given in the first place is when a critical review of subject is actually being written about something, or if someone genuinely asks, how can I improve on something I've just made? I mean, that being said, it can still be very difficult to give proper feedback even when it's asked for. You'll ask yourself things like, how honest should I be? Should I start with the good things first or the bad things first? Or will they be offended if I point out something that was really obvious in the first place? And this is where it becomes appropriate to use something called the feedback sandwich. A slice of good stuff to start, some suggested improvements in the middle, and a slice of good stuff to end. So positive, negative, positive. Now, an example of using the feedback sandwich would look something like, hey Jeremy, that was a really good performance on stage. I really liked how dynamic you were, how fluid your movements were, and I think your costume as a whole was really well constructed. But maybe just a few small things to consider. The props that you made, the quality and the construction of them weren't quite up to scratch with the rest of your costume, which was really well made by the way. And the audio in your skits, I felt like it really wasn't as intense as it could have been. So maybe in future you could consider spending a little bit more time on your props and make it match with the rest of your costume so it fits together as a whole. And when you're recording your skits, don't be afraid to really just shout into the microphone, because I felt with a bit more intensity and presence in your voice, you really could have made that skit a few extra levels of exciting of what I think it really could have been. Anyway, those are just some really small things to consider, but overall I think you've done an amazing job and I'm really proud of what you've made. So best of luck for the rest of the competition and I really can't wait to see what you come up with next. Good feedback should be honest, should be assertive, and it should be kind all at the same time. So when you're giving feedback, make a sandwich. Depending on how feedback is given or received, it can really have a pretty big impact on the future of a cosplayer or of an artist, you know. Sometimes they might take the feedback on board in a really good way and it can be delivered really well, and they can use it as motivation to really improve and create something even better for the future. But at the same time, if it's not really taken well or if it's not delivered in a really good way, it can unfortunately become really demotivating to somebody and they might not really want to make anything ever again. So when you're receiving feedback, it's always good to try to take as many different opinions as you can on board, but take it with a grain of salt and make your own decisions so you can filter out what you think is actually good advice and which people are actually just being nasty. And when asked to give feedback, ideally you don't want to be that mean, harsh dude who just thinks that they know it all, and you don't really want to be that kind of dude who is too scared to give someone useful advice because they were too afraid of upsetting somebody. So whether it be as a judge or as a friend or a complete stranger, make a sandwich. Be honest, be kind, and be assertive all at the same time. And that, in my opinion, is how to give good advice without being a wanker. But should you listen to me? Is it actually good feedback? Well, what we talked about before. That's up to you to decide. G'day fellas, thanks so much for watching. Anyway, I want to hear about some feedback or some criticism that you've received about your cosplayers before. Maybe it was from a judge, was it from a parent, was it from a friend, was it from a random stranger, someone on the internet maybe? Was it good, was it bad? Let me know in the comments below. This weekend is Brisbane Supernova. It's going to be the very last convention of the year that I'll be attending. And with the weather getting extremely hot around here, it's going to be a really good time for us to bust out all of those summer-related cosplays. But it should be a lot of fun, and if you guys are attending this weekend, I might catch you there. As always guys, thanks very much for watching. Really appreciate you, really appreciate the support, and I will catch you in another video next week.